medicine section, vaccines. RS asks, a one-year-old receives two vaccines after the parent was counseled, DT and IM injectable poliomyelitis. How to code vaccines and administration. Does the order of the vaccines matter? And maybe, Alicia, I got to get my document camera going. Maybe you could read the answer for that while I find this.
I like how Lorraine put this. This is a stick and stuff scenario. So we need a code to describe the administration or stick and one or more for the vaccines or stuff. And know the order of the vaccine does not matter. So she's going to pull up the CPT so you can actually see this.
Yeah, I'm going to go to 458. Okay, good. Phew, it worked. I forgot to test it. That's why I was panicking a little bit. Okay, so this is where the guidelines start. And for me, when I was first learning how to code, I need to do funny little word games. So stick and stuff made me remember, oh, administration and the product, the vaccine or the immune globulin, if you're talking about that. So you have to make sure you're using the right stick code with the right stuff code. So here it's telling us to report vaccine immunization administration codes with this range, which is coming next, in addition to the vaccine, i.e. product codes. And this is one of the rare instances in CPT where they actually do have codes for a product or a thing or an item. Most of those we find in HCPCS, okay? So let's take a look at 459. And what I've started to do with my bubbling and highlighting. Oh, which by the way, I forgot to tell Boyd to make the announcement. Bubbling and highlighting is an official trademarked term by codingcertification.org. So yay, I'm trademarked. So 90.
Really? Congratulations.
Thanks. So this bubble here, 90460, I labeled it vaccine toxoid stick, okay? And I did the same thing for 471 and 472. So now what we need to do is figure out, well, what's the difference between these two groups? So this one is through 18 years of age via any route of administration with counseling. So this is where that counseling comes in. And this is the first or only component of each vaccine or toxoid administered. And then the 461 is each additional. Okay. Now the next grouping is talking about percutaneous, intradermal, sub-Q, or intramuscular injections, one vaccine. Now, you'll notice here, it doesn't talk about counseling, okay? So if we wanted to, we could even just say with counseling. And then here, no counsel. And that's really what you want to do throughout your book. Find the differences so that when you go to take a board exam or in real world coding, you can quickly compare and contrast and pick out the best one. And then the third bubble is oral or nasal. Okay, so intranasal or oral. So for our question, let's see what she said. So here she has injectable. Okay, and it did talk about counseling and it's a 1 year old. Okay, so we can see that we're going to be in this bubble here, the 460 bubble. Okay, and then what comes next after the stick codes is the stuff codes, and you can see the guidelines are talking about vaccines, toxoids, and stuff. Okay, so we've got it's on the next page here. Okay, so then what I like to do with these is I kind of bracket when they have the same name. So 90476 and 90477, it's not a true bubble when you learn how to do bubbling and highlighting because we only bubble in indented codes. So this is, I should have called it bubbling, highlighting, and bracketing. But these are both the adenovirus. And then you want to look at the difference. This is a type 4, this is type 7, and, you know, oral use, etc. So what you would do, what did she say she had? Poliomyelitis. Let me see if I can find that real quick here. If anyone finds it, type it in. Polio. I found some of the
I used to
detail.
have it memorized and I don't know.
Pardon?
I used to have it memorized and I don't remember
Oh,
what
here it
letter
is, 90712 and 3. Okay, and so you see live for oral use and sub-Q. So we know the route of administration was an injection. So it's got to be the 90713. Okay, so that's how you do it. You do the same thing for the DT, the diphtheria and tetanus, I think it is. Okay, so stick and stuff. Hopefully that will help you remember that one.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.